pit, the animals inside came out to play. Went face to face with all our fears, learned our lessons through the tears, made memories we knew would never fade. One day my father, he told me, son, don't let it slip away. He took me in his arms, I heard him say, when you get older, your wild heart will live for younger days. Think of me if ever you're afraid. He said one day you'll leave this world behind, so live a life you will remember. My father told me when I was just a child, these are the nights to never die. My father told me,
amazing to have this opportunity to be a Pathfinder nominee.
Honestly, it's a great honor.
It feels amazing.
I'm shocking. Absolutely shocking. I didn't expect this at all.
I wouldn't have expected it, but it's an amazing feeling.
Nervous.
Oh, it feels great. It feels amazing being here. It's a blessing.
Excited.
Oh, it's fantastic.
It's a privilege to be here.
It's great. It feels amazing.
Excited.
Feeling pretty good.
It feels really good. I'm really honored to be one of the nominations.
It's honored to be a nominee right now.
Beyond Kincaid.
I'm just very excited.
Really an honor, actually. It's a privilege to be one of the top kids at my school.
I'm very proud and excited to represent my community.
It feels great.
Excited! Surprising, but very exciting.
These young people are so with it. They've got so much credentials. They got so much drive and desire. They're incredible.
The candidates are phenomenal. They've overcome so many things to be able to get to be the successful individuals that they are.
This class was by far one of the best.
It was a wonderful day for the judges, for sure, to meet such wonderful young people.
Great talent here in Palm Beach County. We're really proud.
Wow. 2017 is the most incredible class I've ever seen.
Do sports management.
I want to become a physician and go into public health.
I want to be an automotive engineer.
I'd like to become a defense attorney.
I would like to become a psychiatrist.
Advertising or personal relations.
Be successful however I get there.
Come back to the Glades and work in agriculture.
I want to be a forensic analyst.
I want to join the U.S. Navy.
I'd like to be a strength and conditioning coach for professional athletes.
To pursue like a graduate degree, I'm looking into like microbiology program.
I want to be a nurse practitioner.
To go into medical school and
become a guidance counselor and help others.
Be an investment banker.
I want to be a physicist.
A chiropractor.
An FBI communications liaison.
I want to be a general physician.
I want to work with the Palm Beach Sheriff's Office actually.
Entrepreneur, veterinarian.
I plan to pursue musical theater.
Successful business executive, perhaps working in New York.
I want to work as an emergency room doctor,
be an environmental scientist, and then possibly go into the Peace Corps.
I would like to start my own business in the computer science.
I want to open my own medical practice.
To be an architect and design future big buildings.
Work for like a big TV company.
MFA to like a Juilliard at NYU, and then Broadway, and then the rest of the world. So we'll see what life takes me.
Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome to the stage, the publisher of the Palm Beach Post, Tim Burke.
Good evening and welcome to the 34th Annual Pathfinder Awards Ceremony, proudly presented by the Palm Beach Post. Each year, you can applaud. Each year, I stand here and can actually feel the excitement, feel the anticipation, even feel your butterflies. However, don't take it from me right now. I'd like to hear from all of you. How do you feel tonight? All right, as you see on the screen behind me, real news starts here this evening. So I'd like to start with some real numbers to get everyone's attention. We have 594 outstanding Pathfinder nominees in the House tonight. The Palm Beach Post has given more than $2.85 million in Pathfinder scholarships since 1984. And tonight, we will hand out more than $209,000 to our Community and Pathfinder Award winners. Now, of course, it is not all about the money, because every nominee here this evening deserves our appreciation and applause for representing themselves, their schools, their families, and our communities so very well. To our Pathfinder nominees themselves, you are here, remember, because you represent the best of the very best of Palm Beach and Martin counties, because you embrace that extra challenge, the extra coursework, and the extra community service. You are also here because it requires more than just smarts and skill, more than SAT and ACT scores. You are here because it also requires an authenticity of character and commitment. In my view, the definition of being cool today is being real today. Simply put, one can't fake his or her way to your levels of achievement that are being recognized tonight. You can't fake your way through multiple AP classes or through those grueling interviews at PBA, as you and the Pathfinder judges will attest. Now, everyone has heard by this time of fake news, right? In my line of work, where our authenticity and our credibility is under siege seemingly every day, my advice to you is the same that I give to our outstanding staff of journalists. When you are challenged, stay true to who you are and never sacrifice the personal credibility and integrity that got you here tonight. As you head to college in a few months, determining what's real and who's real will be part of that journey. That has always been the case, but never more so than today, when our world has become so social and so instantaneous. How will you know what is the truth? Whom you should trust? What is fake? What is real? I have some news that I'd like to share, some fake, some real, that might help you answer those questions when you take your talents to a college campus near and far. First, some fake news that I know many of you have heard before. That is, you must decide on a major right now, stick to it, graduate in 4 years or less, and start working in your field, oh, maybe 2 weeks after you earn your degree. Here's the real news or advice. You are 17 and 18. You have plenty of time to decide. And if you have already decided, you have plenty of time to change your mind. And when you graduate, yes, think about grad school, but maybe not before thinking about a gap year. At some point, give yourself a break. If any group deserves it, you do. Some more fake news. Your generation doesn't know how to communicate. You are always on your smartphone, texting, Snapchatting, thereby making you completely incapable of having a conversation longer than 5 seconds. Fake news. Now the real news. Well, first of all, I heard the Pathfinder judges couldn't get you all to shut up. For starters. In reality, your generation communicates more than any before it, making you our most productive and conversive generation ever. If technology is our future, and it clearly is, our future is very bright in your hands and your fingers. So keep on texting. More fake news. You don't read news. Thereby, you're not well informed. You've heard that. Here's the real news. According to numerous studies, and in my business, I study numerous studies, more than 85% of millennials keep up with the news, typically on social platforms. And this is striking and super encouraging. You are more open-minded than the average news consumer, more open to hearing both sides of an issue. When you listen to both sides, when you have all the facts, it is far easier to differentiate between what's real and what's not. My last piece of fake news. College is easy. College is hard. College is one big party. And the real news. College isn't defined so easily or rigidly. What college is very different every day. It is a freedom that you will have never had and an experience that just can't be predicted. Go with it. This is what makes it exciting, illuminating, invigorating, yes, sometimes frightening, and definitely life-altering. In other words, it is the real deal, just like every one of you. Congratulations to each of the amazingly talented Pathfinder nominees here tonight. Now it is time to start handing out awards. Are we ready? So, to begin our special community awards, we will start with the Pride Awards. To announce the Pride Awards is Rick Christie, editor of the editorial page at the Palm Beach Post.
Good evening. This is the 34th year that the program to recognize initiative and distinction in education has been conducted in Martin County. The program recognizes seniors who have demonstrated academic excellence in one of four areas: mathematics, science, social studies, or writing. Winners are selected by their school district. Now, I would be remiss if I would not mention right now that I am a proud Martin County native and a graduate of Martin County High School in 1978. Now, each of the four winners will receive a $500 scholarship from the Palm Beach Post. I'd like the winners to come up on stage when I call your name to get your award. Okay, for mathematics, Oscar Sura, Southport High School. For science, Shantanu Jakit, Southport High School. And Shantanu, yes. All right, for social studies, Julie Bilecki, Jensen Beach High School. I know a sad soul. writing, Emily Mila, Martin County High School. Untouchable.
My name is no, my sign is no, my number is no. You need to let it go, you need to let it go, need to let it go.
Tonight, we welcome back the Audubon Society of the Everglades, which will award a scholarship to one of the science nominees. Representing this society is a member of its scholarship committee, Jack McLaughlin.
For more than 40 years, the Audubon Society of the Everglades has supported the protection of not only birds, but all wildlife and its native local habitat. Ruth and Seymour Miller were visionaries and realized that the conservation of water quality and the air we breathe is an ongoing responsibility. For this reason, the Audubon Society of the Everglades recognizes a science nominee in their honor for outstanding achievement in the field of environmental science. The Audubon Society of the Everglades is proud to award the 2017 Ruth and Seymour Miller $3,000 scholarship to Jessica Young from Palm Beach Central High School. Jessica has a long history of activities, studies, and research dealing with water quality in the South Florida environment. She was the Green School Student of the Year for our area in 2016 as a Pine Jog Fellow. She will be furthering these studies next year at Florida Atlantic University Honors College in Jupiter. Unfortunately, Jessica isn't able to be with us this evening. She is currently a finalist in presenting her research at the Intel International and Science Fair in Los Angeles today. We wish her good luck. Receiving the award for Jessica is Brittany Billis, the Pathfinder Coordinator at Palm Beach Central High School.
Tonight, we also welcome the Brianna Marie Cox Foundation, Ms. Barbara Gadosh, Foundation President, and her daughter, Rebecca, will make the presentation.
Good evening. When a child is developing, achieving milestones, and attempting to overcome the challenges of everyday life, it can be catastrophic to experience the life of an immediate family member. Our family knows all too well as we live through the sting of death, as we experienced a family's worst nightmare. The loss of our 17-year-old daughter, our beautiful, beloved Brianna Marie Cox. As a parent, I witnessed our own children grieve the loss of their sister and fight to persevere on their personal and academic level. And this is what has birthed the Brianna Marie Cox Foundation Perseverance Scholarship Award. Our foundation was established to help families in their darkest hours after an immediate loss of a family member. In total, the foundation has given nearly $170,000 to help families. Of this amount, we have humbly awarded nearly $90,000 in scholarships alone. Tonight, we are here to recognize and celebrate their perseverance and accomplishments.
The Brianna Marie Cox Foundation has chosen four graduating seniors who have experienced the sting of death. These students were not selected primarily upon their GPA, but rather the decisions they made after they experienced the loss of an immediate family member. It was these decisions that impacted the Brianna Marie Cox Foundation. Tonight, we are giving $9,500 in scholarships monies. The Brianna Marie Cox Foundation has chosen three students who will receive anywhere from $1,500 to $2,500. These students will not take the stage, yet it is our honor and pleasure to announce Janelle Barrick from John I. Leonard High School, Jamisha Kendall from Inlet Grove High School, Felix Pagoa from Jensen Beach High School. Our first place winner, who will be taking the stage with us and will receive $3,000 in scholarships monies, is Justin Warwick from Lake Worth High School. After the sudden loss of his father, Justin became a source of strength for his mom and stepmom. Justin plans to attend Palm Beach State College and intends to major in communications. Thank you to all of our winners. You've inspired us.
The Executive Women of the Palm Beaches will be awarding the Cynthia Allen Gracie Memorial Scholarship this evening. To make the presentation is its president, Lori Fisher.
Good evening, Pathfinder nominees, families, and honored guests. My name is Lori Fisher. I'm the 35th president of Executive Women of the Palm Beaches. The Cynthia Allen Gracie Scholarship Award is named after our late founder and visionary, Cynthia Allen Gracie, who recently passed away this January. Cynthia was committed to women leadership and empowering women to lead and succeed. I must tell you how difficult it was to be able to pick a winner out of all the outstanding nominees. But I think Cynthia would agree that our scholarship recipient is one of Palm Beach County's best and brightest students destined for greatness. I would like to take this time to congratulate all of the nominees on their achievement and wish you all a tremendous amount of success tonight and in the future. The name of our winner is Hannah Bushbaum from William T. Dwyer High School. Hannah excels both inside and outside the classroom as a role model for her entire student body. Her talent and intelligence make her a valuable contributor to achieve any goal she sets for herself in the future. Executive Women of the Palm Beaches is proud to award Hannah the Cynthia Allen Gracie Scholarship for $3,000 on behalf of Executive Women of the Palm Beaches. Please join me in congratulating Hannah.
The Kantner Foundation has joined us once again this year and will be awarding four Kantner Foundation Scholar Awards. The foundation is also once again sponsoring the business category. Thank you. We welcome Thomas Silverman and Richard Jarchow to the podium.
Thank you. Good evening, everyone. My name is Thomas Silverman, and with me is Richard Jarchow. We're members of the Board of Trustees of the Kantner Foundation. Tonight, as Mr. Burke announced, we're giving four scholarships for outstanding service to the community and in business categories, two in each. Earlier this week, we gave 25 scholarships to people who were applicants to our website directly, which we do throughout the entire year. For those of you that don't know much about the Cantner Foundation, I'm just going to say a few words to introduce the subject. The Cantner Foundation this year actually is 30 years of age. Woody Cantner, our founder, was a real estate investor, developer, and philanthropist. He began a career selling used cars in Fort Lauderdale. And every morning he told me he would chase the alligators off of the lot in order to start a business. And he had a best customer, someone who would come regularly and buy cars from him. Finally, he got up the nerve to ask this person, what do you do for a living? How can you come and buy cars here regularly? And the person said, well, I'm in real estate. So Woody knew that moment that he is destined or should be destined to go into real estate, which he did. He developed property in South Florida, Maine, and in the Midwest. He's most well known for putting the deal together, and most of his property was involved in the condemnation of the property that became the Martin County exit on I-95. But Woody believed in giving back to the community, and the Cantner Foundation tonight sponsors scholarships in the business category and community involvement. With me tonight to present the awards is Richard Jarkow.
Good evening. We have four awards. They are $3,000 each. The first two will be community involvement, and our first recipient is Isabella Fusinga. Isabella is going to be graduating from the Pine School. She is a co-founder of Ellie's Belly's Shop, a nonprofit greeting card business whose profits are now donated to local organizations that support children's literacy programs. They have donated three lending libraries, which are handcrafted bookshelves filled with over 1,500 books for children of all ages. And she served her community as a volunteer in numerous places, include deputy and head of the Pine School Outreach Program promoting community service opportunities for fellow students. She's been a volunteer at the Hobie Sound Nature Center as an animal care volunteer and docent, and the list goes on and on. She will be attending Washington and Lee University in Lexington, Virginia. Congratulations. Our second recipient in the community involvement category is Sabrina Ginsburg. Sabrina attended American Heritage School and has been a volunteer for the American Parkinson's Disease Association for the past 9 years in various fundraising capacities that include choreographing a dance, recruiting 80 volunteers, and organizing annual picnics and walks, including the Optimism Walk. Her efforts have raised thousands of dollars over the years. She currently serves as president of the Inner Club Council and Vice President of the Student Government, where she leads her school's charitable efforts. And again, just with all of the students, you could list, and the list goes on and on. Sabrina, you will be attending
the University of Miami.
University of Miami in the fall. Sabrina, there you go. Thank you. Our next recipient and this is in the business slash entrepreneurship category, is Mark Hitzig. Mark.
And I don't know no better, but as far as I came, it felt like forever. Seconds turn to hours, days turn to months, let a year pass by.
Mark has been attending St. Andrew's School, and he served as president and vice president of his school's Junior Achievement chapter, where he successfully has helped launch a campaign to sell over 250 cell chargers, where the proceeds were donated to charity. In addition to that, he's the founder and president of a drone-based aerial photography business, where he has built a clientele of over 16 area realtors and earned his commercial drone license. Mark will be attending the Massachusetts Institute of Technology, otherwise known as MIT, in Cambridge, Mass, and plans to major in business analytics. Congratulations, Mark. And our final recipient is Tarang Patel. Has attended the Palm Beach Central High School and was one of the key organizers and fundraisers for his school's National Honor Society Signature Project, which is a dance marathon fundraiser, where through his efforts, a record $22,000 was raised, making Palm Beach Central High School the number one high school in Florida. He is also an active, he's also active in the Future Business Leaders of America, the Key Club, and Environmental Society, where he is currently the president. The Future Business Leaders of America awarded him third place in districts for public service in 2016, third place in districts for marketing in 2014. And here's a statistic. He's ranked number one in his graduating class of 754. And Tarang will be going to the University of Florida this fall. And that concludes our presentation. Thank you.
Okay, tonight the South Florida Fair is awarding its community scholarship tonight. Becky Eisminger, Fair Trustee and Chair of the Scholarship Committee, will make the presentation.
For a walk-up song, and he gave me Big Green Tractor. Nice job. good evening. I'm so honored to once again be able to represent the South Florida Fair and Palm Beach County Expositions to award our scholarship. We present a scholarship with the support of FPL in the amount of total scholarships given over $36,000. So the one tonight we're giving is in the amount of $3,000. And since our fair serves Martin County, Palm Beach, Broward, Hendry, and Okeechobee, any student from any of those counties can get our scholarship. And we award our scholarships in a variety of categories. Tonight's winner is in the area of community involvement, and that's our Pathfinder Scholarship. To fund these scholarships, we have funds designated from our year-round operations, and we have a scholarship golf tournament. The scholarship applications open in the fall for any of you who may have younger siblings or friends. With the exception of this one, they're all awarded during the fair. But this one is now, and if you are interested, anybody who's any younger out there, any parents, go to our website and you'll see all our scholarship information. And in addition to the fair, the fairgrounds hosts a lot of different things. One of it is the graduations that are coming up. So most of you are going to be graduating and being at our fairgrounds. Tonight's winner is a man who has done amazing things in the area of community involvement. He started a 501c3 and donated over 750 hours to this, and it's called Bricks Busting Boredom. And this young man collects Legos, and they get donated to children's hospitals and to homeless shelters. So I'm presenting tonight's award to Mr. Daniel Klein from Wellington High School. If you notice, he's got a little Lego on with little eyeballs in it, so isn't that cute? But thank you so much. Hope all y'all have fun graduating at the fairgrounds this year. Thank you. This is great.
All right, from the fair to Sunfest. We are happy to welcome Sunfest again this year to present the annual Sunfest Music Scholarship is Patty Hammond, President-elect.
Good evening, everybody. I'm very honored to be here tonight to present the award on behalf of Sunfest. How many of you actually went to Sunfest this year? Did you have a good time? Of course. It was a very tough decision on deciding who would win this award, because there was a lot of talented musicians that came to Palm Beach Atlantic. And the winner that we have, that we chosen, is a jazz. He loves jazz. He plays multiple instruments. And he plays in a band, and he wants to major in music. The award that we're giving out tonight is a $4,000 scholarship, and we are going to present it to Andre Sudol from Oxbridge Academy of Palm Beaches. Bye now. Good luck, everybody.
Okay, now we have the honor of presenting the Palm Beach Post scholarships. To present our first special scholarship, the Minority Scholarship in Journalism Award, is Keeley Gideon Taylor, Community Relations and Special Events Supervisor for the Post.
This is the 27th year the Palm Beach Post has sponsored the Minority Scholarship Program for Journalism. The scholarship was established to provide financial assistance and practical experience to students pursuing a degree in journalism. The honoree receives a $4,000 cash award and two paid internships at the Palm Beach Post. I am pleased to announce the 2017 recipient, Valeria Muniz.
You'll always be by my side.
Valeria is a member of the National Honor Society, Spanish Honor Society, and National English Honor Society at Boca Raton High School. She excelled as a staff writer and copy editor for the school's newspaper, The Paw Print. So her elevation to co-editor-in-chief was definitely deserved. Valeria is an exceedingly endorsed for this scholarship due to her passion, skills, and commitment to journalism. She flourished as a writer, editor, and emerged as a dependable and hardworking leader for the Paw Print. She showcased her talents with articles that captivated a mature look at human interest stories. She covered security measures enforced after a student brought a gun to campus, the resilience of immigrants, as well as lighter topics that appeal to her peers and adults. Scholarship judge M. Mendez said it best, Valeria stood out among the field of candidates as the most eager and insightful and prepared. Her writing sample showed good experience with reporting, and her natural curiosity will suit her well as a news interviewer. Valeria will attend the Florida Atlantic University pursuing a degree in journalism. Congratulations, Valeria. So I have that for you and this for you. Congratulations. Good to see you.
For the final special scholarships tonight, Nick Michella, editor of the Palm Beach Post, will present our sons and daughters scholarships.
Good evening. It gives me great pleasure to announce the recipients of the Sons and Daughters Scholarship Fund for the children of employees of the Palm Beach Post and the Palm Beach Daily News. To ensure impartiality, sons and daughters of our employees are excluded from Pathfinder nominations at their schools. However, we have established a program to recognize their achievements and help them with their future education. I would ask that this year's winners come forward and receive their award from our publisher, Tim Burke. Going alphabetically, our first winner is Armand Bayek. Armand's keen engineering foresight may catapult him into the annals of American history of inventors and contributors, or he may be courted by the EPA to capitalize on his dedication to reducing vehicle emissions that are harmful to the environment. He recognized how entrenched computers have become in our lives and is determined to pioneer a way to combine technology, information about traffic systems, and ongoing tests with self-driving cars to help save lives, time, and the environment. He's earned several awards for academic excellence, including AP Scholar with Distinction while attending Suncoast Community High School. He's also an Eagle Scout. He has participated in community service to protect beaches from erosion, raise money for various charities, and to benefit the Science Center. He plans to pursue a degree in computer science and has myriad of options of universities across the country. Armand is the son of Ron Falk, newspaper shared services copy desk for the Palm Beach Post. Our next winner is Ethan Fote. Ethan credits his father and his adventures as a Boy Scout with his fascination with the environment. This instilled in him, at an early age, a resolve to seek a career that will provide him with the same satisfaction he experiences when outdoors, whether on land or on sea. In 2016, he earned the rank of Eagle Scout, an extension of his commitment to becoming an effective leader, helping others, and cultivating respect for the environment. As an honors student at Suncoast Community High School, he is also enrolled in Palm Beach State College and has a part-time job. He's maintained exceptional grades while leading Suncoast's volleyball team to win the district championship 2 years in a row, in addition to building archery sheds for the Everglades Youth Camp for his Eagle Project. Ethan has volunteered with the Race for the Cure and Feed the Hungry. He plans to attend the University of Central Florida to pursue a degree in environmental engineering. Ethan is the son of Janie Fote, Special Projects Coordinator for the Palm Beach Post. Congratulations to our sons and daughters scholarship recipients.
As I mentioned earlier, this is the 34th year that we have presented the Pathfinders Scholarship Awards. Pathfinders is actually a 501c3 nonprofit organization. All of the scholarship money comes from a charitable trust, the NNDS Franklin Fund, which is a permanent endowment left to Pathfinders. This evening, all administrative costs and tonight's ceremony are paid for by the Palm Beach Post. We are taking this opportunity to partner with Great Give, a one day of giving facilitated by our friends at the United Way, and ask that you make a donation, if you wish, to Pathfinders, either online or by using the envelopes in your program book. Thank you for helping us keep the endowment strong. We want to thank Palm Beach Atlantic University for being such a wonderful partner. It has hosted our interview day on campus for the past 25 years. And this night would not be so memorable if it wasn't for our special partnership with the Kravis Center. It's an amazing venue, would you not agree? We have been celebrating Pathfinders here for 25 years as well. Now, before we start the Pathfinder Awards, we present our tribute to the 597 nominees of 2017.
Go Scots!
Once again, congratulations to all of our nominees. And now to present the 2017 Pathfinder Awards, please welcome Janie Fote, Special Projects Coordinator for the Palm Beach Post.
Thank you. Thank you, Tim. You know, we've been celebrating amazing high school seniors for 34 years, all 15,000. Yep, I counted them all over all the 34 years, and there have been 15,000 Pathfinder nominees, shining stars out in the world doing fantastic things. That's you guys. Congratulations. But you know, also that got me thinking of all the thousands of parents that have supported all of those nominees. So tonight, in celebration for the dedicated support team that you guys have, I'd like all our high school seniors to stand and give a round of applause to their parents. Aww. I'm kind of partial to the parents because my youngest is graduating and I'm celebrating right there with you. So congratulations, parents. As you know, there are 18 Pathfinder categories. In each category, the first place winner receives $4,000, second place $3,000, and the third place $2,500. So, to present the awards tonight for Technical Vocational Agricultural is Deborah Nichols, architect with D.L. Nichols. Deborah?
Wow, how exciting to be here tonight. And before I announce the winners, I know you're waiting. I do want to say congratulations to all the nominees. I think you should pat yourselves on the back. Job well done to everyone. Now, without further ado, third place winner for this category is Doris Cabrera from Glade Central High School. Second place is Alec Gray, Olympic Heights High School. And the winner is Nadia Sial, FAU High School. High school, Nadia Sial was also working on her undergraduate degree in neuroscience and behavioral at FAU. She expects to earn in August of 2017. By then, she will have completed the pre-health profession certificate and logged over 150 shadowing hours in preparation for entering medical school in the fall of 2018. While dual enrolled, Nadia has tutored FAU undergraduate students in science subjects, including biology, chemistry 1 and 2, and biological basis of behavior. She was also a teaching assistant for general chemistry 1, teaching discussion lectures 3 times weekly, proctoring exams, and grading assignments. Nadia is a national merit semifinalist, been named regional, state, and national championship in the Academic Games League of America, and earned medals at local and state levels in the Invitational Science Olympiad. Congratulations.
And our next category is sports. Our presenter, Chris Purcell, is not able to be here this evening, so I will have the honor to award the sports category. Okay. Third place, Tyrone Arnett, Pahokee High School. Second place, Tia Tripodi, Park Vista High School. And our winner in the sports category is Leanne Hewitt, Wellington High School. graduate is on track to qualify for the 2020 Olympics in Tokyo for weightlifting. She already holds 12 International Powerlifting Federation world records, is a member of Team USA for raw powerlifting and for equipped powerlifting, and is a member of the 2016 youth training camp at the Olympic Training Center. And it gets better, it gets better. For USA Powerlifting, she is the best female teen lifter, the best overall female lifter for deadlift, and best overall female lifter for combined bench press and deadlift. It gets better. Leanne is in the top 3% of her class and earned the AICE diploma with distinction. And she's accomplished all this and more while managing type 2 diabetes. Oh my gosh. And her plans for her future are to become a cardiothoracic surgeon. Congratulations. That's a superwoman right there. Our next category is science, and to present that award is a new judge this year, Dr. Cydia Grant, Assistant Professor of Chemistry at Palm Beach Atlantic University. Cydia.
Good evening, everyone. It is my pleasure to present the awards to the following recipients in the science category. Third place, Jason Kaufman, Suncoast High School. Second place, Stefan Wan, Dreyfus School of the Arts. And the winner is Shantanu Jacquet, South Fork High School. Shantanu is not here tonight. We have someone to accept his award on his behalf. He's competing in the International Science and Engineering Fair in Los Angeles. However, let me tell you something about this amazing young man. Shantanu is already being taken seriously in the science world. His mosquito research was published in the Journal of Medical Entomology in January 2017. And several articles by and about him and his work have been published since 2015. He's been an invited speaker at conferences, including addressing scientists at the Florida Entomological Society to present work that began as a science fair project on the attraction of male mosquitoes to the sound of female wing beats. Other accomplishments include Regeneron STS 2017 Scholar Semifinalist, first place winner of the awards from USAID Global Development Lab Innovation and Arizona State University Sustainability Initiatives at Intel ISCF 2016. He's also one of the 20 students selected at the first World Championship 2016 for FIRST's robotics competition team. Shantanu wants to major in mechanical and aerospace engineering and eventually design spacecrafts. Once again, a hearty congratulations to Shantanu.
To present the awards for the Reach for Excellence category is Sue Caplia, a retired Palm Beach County teacher. Sue?
Good evening. Reach for Excellence is a very unique category for Pathfinders that honors students that have individual learning differences and have overcome this battle of learning in a variety of ways. In the world, learning is perceived as fun. Not everyone finds it that way. Our candidates find that their brain's ability to receive and process information is different from others. It may manifest in reading, dyslexia, math, written expression, short or long-term memory retrieval, anxiety, or any combination thereof. These differences have impacted each of our nominees. They have learned through weaknesses of basic skills, to learn strategies and techniques, to overcome, compensate, and compete in an academic rigor throughout every year of their schooling. As judges, we have the pleasure to meet and hear each unique individual story and how they have succeeded in those struggles. And now may we honor this year's winners in a very special category, Reach for Excellence. Our third place winner is Alejandro Colas of Olympic Heights High School. Second place is Samantha Bashweiner of Suncoast High School. And the winner is Victoria Moses, Chicago Vista. Suffering from dyslexia, Victoria Moses has made academic strides beyond the average high school student. She has managed to maintain no less than a 3.5 GPA for all 4 years of high school and is in the top 9% of her class while duly enrolled at the University of Florida. Her academic achievements have led her to be inducted into the National Honor Society, the National Math Honor Society, National English Honor Society, National Spanish Honor Society, and the Science National Honor Society. She says dyslexia gave her the drive to show others that nothing can hold you back from living up to your potential as long as you do not let it. Victoria plans to pursue her PhD in biomedical engineering so she'll be able to help others with disabilities. Congratulations.
To present the awards for the music vocal category is Missy McCardle, an 8-time Carbonell nominee. She is a local cabaret singer and a regular performer at the Wick Theater in Boca Raton. Missy?
On behalf of my fellow judges, Michael McMullen and Charles Damsel, I think I can say without reservation that judging this particular capacity of the Pathfinders is so exciting and so rewarding. We would have chosen you all if we could have, but we had to limit it to three. I personally applaud you for having the courage to get up and sing like you do at 8 o'clock in the morning. So you have my applause. The third place nominee winner tonight is Carla McHenry from John I. Leonard High School. Second place goes to Anthony Capizzi from South Fork High School. And the winner of the 2017 Pathfinder Award for Vocal is Victoria Bartolotta, Martin County High School. tell you quite honestly, everybody was good, but there's always one who walks in and takes your breath away, and this was Victoria. Victoria made her mark on the Treasure Coast as an artist by winning the 2016 Martyrs Award for Outstanding Student Performer, the county's highest performing arts award. She is a frequent actress and singer on the local and regional stages in productions such as A Chorus Line, Pippin, and Gypsy, and was the district's Critics' Choice Award winner and a semifinalist for the Watch a Rising Star competition. Victoria performed in a fundraising gala alongside Vanessa Williams and collaborated with composer Stephen Schwartz. Victoria also performs at Artists for a Cause Gala and masterclass events at the Starstruck Youth Arts Theater and was a soloist in her school's top audition choir, Opus. She plans to pursue a Bachelor of Fine Arts degree in musical theater and to perform on Broadway, and I bet she's gonna make it. Congratulations, Victoria.
Susan Merritt, president and founder of the Jazz Arts Music Society, will present the music instrumental category. Susan?
Good evening. I'm very, very honored to be able to announce the winners tonight in the instrumental music category. Our third place winner is Bradley Stromoski from Suncoast High School. Second place, Megan Ahern, Dreyfus School of the Arts. Our first place winner tonight is Jada Campbell, American Heritage School. Jada Campbell has performed and competed as a classical pianist since age 4. She has won numerous awards in international, state, and regional competitions. In the 11th grade, she performed twice at Carnegie Hall after placing first at the American Fine Arts Federation Romantic Music Competition and second at the American Protégé International Piano and Strings Competition. Outside of school, Jada, a National Merit semifinalist, tutors piano students, some of whom have gone on to win awards. Jada is also gifted in math and plans to study both piano performance and computer science in college. She hopes to combine her talents in both areas to use technology to analyze music and to design machines and software that can collect data in the form of music and lyrics to help in musical production. Well done, Jada. Congratulations.
Daksha Chokshi, a senior technical fellow with Aerojet Rocketdyne, will present our mathematics award.
Thank you, Jenny. First of all, I would like to thank my fellow Pathfinder mathematics judges, John Ochipini and Jim Sweek, for their outstanding support and contribution to the mathematics Pathfinder winner selection process. It was very challenging to select the recipient of the 2017 Mathematics Pathfinder Award, as we had a wonderful group of so many bright nominees. Nonetheless, our winners are as follows. Third place, Jerry Young from Suncoast High School. Second place, Trevor Marcus from West Boca Raton High School. And our winner is Yuria Aksami from Boca Raton High School.
Everybody take a shot. Red light, green light. Give me everything you got. Red light,
Yuria, the dual enrollment at FAU studying upper division mathematics courses hasn't kept Yuria Atsami from earning numerous academic awards and distinction. In the last two school years alone, she won or placed in more than 15 national, state, regional science Olympic events, including first place in optics, protein modeling, astronomy, and dynamic planet. Last summer, Yuria Math Honor Society co-president studied virtual reality at University of Florida. The summer before, she took a 3-week course in number theory at Brown University. She earned the highest possible ACT scores in math and English and the highest SAT-1 and SAT scores in mathematics. She hopes to combine her talents in mathematics, computer science, and business to work in the financial industry to bring about new and improved efficiency. Congratulations.
It is our pleasure to have Carol Rose with us as a judge for the literature category. Carol is a senior editor with the Palm Beach Post.
Good evening. It is my pleasure to be here. And it was really, really hard for us as judges to finally pick the winners. You guys are so, so talented. You made our job so hard. We were not alone in this category. However, let me go ahead and list the winners. In third place, we have Zui Zhao of the Benjamin School. In second place, we have Catherine Silberstein of St. Andrews. And our winner is Emily Minsky of William T. Dwyer High School.
Because I'm lost, it ain't no show. Because I keep on coming back tomorrow. No, no, no.
Undiscovered nearsightedness until age 7 nudged Emily Minsky into discovering the world through what she calls the artistry of words, books. Once hooked, writing became her passion. In 7th grade, she won a Scholastic Art and Writing National Silver Medal, the first of a string of regional and national writing awards. Her analytical thinking enabled her to become Dwyer's first nationally ranked debater, ranking 26th in the nation for original oratory for the 2016-2017 season. An IB diploma candidate, she scored 5s on AP English Language and Composition and AP English Literature, and 800 on both SAT critical reading and SAT writing. Emily plans to double major in political science and English literature and to eventually work on Capitol Hill, advancing social justice and writing novels in her free time. Congratulations, Emily.
Lonnie Martins, Florida Supreme Court Circuit Civil Mediator and Attorney, is our presenter for the History Political Science category. Lonnie?
Good evening. We, the judges, reviewed the nominees' transcripts, read their personal statements, read letters of recommendation, and finally had the privilege of personally interviewing each nominee, and we finally arrived at a collective decision. It was not easy. I want to say to each of you that we commend you for your commitment to academic excellence, community service, active leadership, and active participation in the field of history and political science, and in your schools. You make a difference. We commend you for striving for balance in your lives by combining extracurricular activities with devotion to your families and your faith. You have made a difference in the world already, and from what we can tell, each one of you is going to be a great success. We know you'll make the world a better place, and we're proud of you, and we wish you all the very best in your future endeavors. This year's scholarship winners in the history and political science category are in third place, Jesse Fox, American Heritage School. Second place, Natalie Poplawski, Suncoast High School. And this year's winner, a long time in coming, Reed Champlin from the King's Academy. As chairman of the King's Academy Model United Nations, Reed directed school efforts to involve students in global affairs and was involved in several activities with the prestigious National High School Model United Nations. When there was no National Social Studies Honor Society at his school, Reed created one. In the meantime, his passion for leadership led him to be named president of the Political Science Club, president of the National Spanish Honor Society, Vice President of the National English Honor Society and Treasurer of the National Science Honor Society, while also being designated a National Merit Commended Scholar and AP Scholar with Honor. He served as a fellow within the Florida Democratic Party and the coordinated campaign to elect Hillary Clinton. He plans to pursue a career in international relations. That's combined with congratulations to Reed. Congratulations. Congratulations to all of you.
To present the award in forensic speech is Bill Bone, trial lawyer with Lemoy and Bone. Bill?
Thank you, Janie. Aristotle of ancient Greece is the first recorded teacher of public speaking, long before football games and track meets and science fairs. The best and brightest students of the most auspicious educational institutions competed against each other by way of the spoken word. Forensics is the term used to describe the various individual and team events which involve public speaking competition. The events range from extemporaneous and impromptu speeches to original oratory, dramatic interpretation, student congress, and all kinds of debate. The most successful students who participate in forensics spend hundreds of hours every week preparing and participating in tournaments locally and all over the nation. We judge the nominees on their individual records as well as their presentation during the interview. All three of the judges attended local high schools and participated in forensics when we were students. And we agree, this year was the most difficult year we've ever had picking the Pathfinder. All of the nominees were exceptional, and these are the finalists. In third place, Lindsay McNamara from William T. Dwyer High School. In second place, Carmen McDaniel from Wellington High School. And the winner is Gregory Seabrooks, Oxbridge Academy of the Palm Beaches. Terrell Seabrooks has participated in forensics all 4 years of high school, and in every year he qualified to attend the national championships. He is especially qualified at parliamentary debate, known as Student Congress, but is also ranked in other events, including public forum debate and extemporaneous speaking. With more than 24 trophies to his credit, almost half of them for first place, Terrell has competed against the best debaters in the nation. His intense pre-debate preparation has given him vast knowledge about an impressive array of topics, including current events, history, and politics. As debate captain and also student government president, Terrell leads practices, gives term lectures, and was the impetus for the debate team's mentoring program designed to help novice members learn the ropes. Terrell is attending Princeton University in the fall. and has been accepted to the prestigious Woodrow Wilson School of Public and International Relations, and I believe he is the man who intends to be politically active as a graduate, and I won't be surprised if he is the one who runs for and is elected President of the United States.
The next category is foreign language and will be presented by Andre Verona, CEO and founder of Verona Insights. Andre?
Thank you, Janie. Good evening. Thank you. I'm truly honored and humbled to be here. I was a first-year judge, so I want to start out by thanking my co-judges, Keatley Williams and Mirella Guerin. Thank you very much for welcoming me the way you did and making this an experience truly a fantastic first-time experience. The students that we met were very inspiring as well, and there were so many worthy candidates. All the teachers and parents should be very, very proud. It's safe to say with students like these, the world and our future is in good hands, so I commend you all. Give yourself a round of applause. The winners in the foreign language category, in third place, Mr. Samuel Rahman from Jupiter High School. In second place, Mr. Pedro Milan from Park Vista High School. And the first place winner, Ms. Hamani Gubi from Sun Coast High School. Hamani is one of very few students in Florida to earn an IB bilingual diploma. She has been recognized for her talents in Spanish with the Gabriel Garcia Marquez Literature Award and by being inducted into the Spanish Honor Society, for which she served as president this year. Hamani has been active in Model UN for 4 years and sees her fluency in Spanish and knowledge of international relations as a stepping stone into the world of diplomacy and politics. Also an excellent science student, Hamani hopes to use her talents to help society on a global scale by becoming an advocate for healthcare and reform in Latin America and among the U.S. Hispanic population. She hopes to eventually work for the World Health Organization or the United Nations. Congratulations, Hamani. Thank you.
To present the awards in drama is Karen Stevens, an award-winning local actress. Karen?
Thank you, Janie. Good evening, it's good to be here. I get up and say this every year, how hard it is coming up with a winner for the drama category. On behalf of my fellow judges, Jody Dixon of the Lake Worth Playhouse and Nanique Garidian of Palm Beach Drama Works, we'd like to commend all of the Pathfinder nominees. If your name isn't called tonight for one of these prizes, do not take that as a personal statement about your talent, because your talent is overwhelming because you are one of the Pathfinder nominees. Just use it as a springboard to bigger and brighter things and a brighter future. Our third place Pathfinder recipient tonight is Ryan Gosling of Royal Palm Beach High School. Second place, Blair Bilton, American Heritage High School. And the 2017 first place Pathfinder recipient
is Maria De Barros, South Florida High School. Almost every aspect of Maria de Barros' life is connected to drama or performing. Over 10 years, she has performed in more than 25 theatrical productions with the lead role in 10. She has been a stage manager, assistant stage manager, director, costume designer, and handled marketing for numerous productions. Maria has volunteered over 300 hours with the Barn Theater, is president of the Drama Club, vice president of the Honors Choir, the Carillon Singers, and donated numerous hours to charitable activities for Artists for a Cause. She won many music and drama-related awards while maintaining a 4.0 average in the rigorous International Baccalaureate program. Yeah, Maria plans to double major in college in technical theater and psychology and hopes to find a theater therapy troupe in college that will help raise awareness of mental health issues. Congratulations, Maria.
We welcome Bruce Whiteley, a longstanding judge for the computer science category and a new Pathfinder board member. Bruce?
Thank you, Janie. On behalf of my other fellow judges, Anisha DeMello and Dan Gallagher, we were very impressed with all of the nominees. When Janie says longstanding, I've done this for about 20 years now, and every year I think we can't possibly see better. But I'd like to echo what Tim Burke and Janie have both said tonight. 2017 is an exceptional class. We had 26 nominees for the computer science category, and that is the most we have ever had in the 20 years that I've been doing this. In third place, Isabella Bond from Suncoast High School. Second place, Anna Darwish from American Heritage School. And this year's Pathfinder winner in computer science is Justin Green from Boca Raton High School. Justin Green has been president of the Computer Science Club for 3 years. During that time, he learned numerous computer languages, been an IT assistant in school, and worked as a freelance web developer. Justin has organized trips to local hackathons, 24-hour coding competitions, and won second place and best presentation at the Major League Hacking DALI Hackathon. Last summer, Justin worked in a biochemistry lab at the University of Florida, where he investigated the antigenetic reactivity profile of the true type AAV2 and mutants. He won accolades for Science Olympiad at regional, state, and national levels, ranking second nationally last year in the protein modeling. He plans a dual major in computer science and biology and wants to work in the field of bacteria and mnemonics, addressing the problem of antibiotic resistance. Congratulations, Justin.
It is my pleasure to introduce Cindy Martin, president of Cindy Martin Incorporated. Ms. Martin is an active member of our community and is also a new Pathfinder board member. Welcome, Cindy.
Thank you. Good evening, everyone. My fellow judges and I interviewed 47 amazing future leaders in the community involvement category. And to say we were impressed would be an understatement. These young adults chose to get involved. They chose to help, and they chose to pay it forward. And that's because of the influence that all of you have had on them. Many times we worry about the future. I sit on my back porch with my husband and lament about what the world is going to be like. I can tell you with confidence, after interviewing these 47 young adults, our future is fine. All the young leaders here tonight, they have a commitment and a passion for learning and to do what's right. And what could be better than that? With them leading the way, it's all good, folks. Thank you. The recipients for community involvement for third place is Christy Tyler from the Dreyfus School of the Arts. Our second place recipient is Renata Tovar from Forest Hill High School. And our overall winner for community involvement is Sabrina Ginsburg from American Heritage. Sabrina Ginsburg says that helping others is a way of life for her. With the goal of completing 1,000 hours of community service before graduation, did you make that? Yay! She's led or participated in numerous causes at school, for nonprofits, and with religious organizations. These include 9 years with the American Parkinson's Disease Association, where as fundraising event chair, as you heard earlier, she choreographed and recruited more than 80 dancers for a dance flash mob to raise awareness for the disease. In the summer of 2015, Sabrina traveled to Poland and volunteered at an orphanage there. She's raised over $1,000 for a child she supports through Education Rocks, which supports the education of underprivileged children in Bali. She plans to study medicine and continue doing volunteer. I could tell my new judge. But continue doing volunteer activities, specifically in the area of Parkinson's disease and movement disorders. Congratulations, Sabrina.
Our next category is communications, and to present this award is Cheryl Crowley, President and CEO of Immediacy Public Relations. Hi, Cheryl.
Hi there. Good evening. We are at a time in communications where we are undergoing fundamental change in how we communicate. Today's generation of future communicators are entering a time like no other, with communications taking new forms, involving new people, and many times having tremendous impact. This also may be the most exciting time to enter this rapidly changing field. And I know I'm echoing quite a few of the judges tonight, but I do have to say that on behalf of my fellow judges, this year is probably the longest we deliberated. You were all just incredibly amazing this year. So, in third place, Matthew Nadell from Dreyfus School of the Arts. In second place, Rhiannon Baffa from Seminole Ridge High School. And the winner, Mia Marks, Olympic Heights High School. Mia Marks' passion for writing began blossoming in her freshman year. That's when she became a reporter for her school's student newspaper, The Torch, while making her mark as a gifted writing student in her English classes. In both 11th and 12th grades, she served as an elite writer, selected by the English department to tutor students struggling with their writing skills. She also scored a 5 on the AP language exam. In her senior year, Mia was named editor-in-chief of The Torch, where she oversaw section editors and reporters. She also wrote an opinion column in each issue, assertively taking on sometimes controversial topics. Mia plans to major in journalism with a minor in English, then join the staff of a newspaper or magazine, joining what she calls a generation of newfound journalistic integrity. Congratulations, Mia.
Our next category is business. Carolyn DiPaolo, senior news editor for the Palm Beach Post, will present this award. Carolyn.
Good evening. It is my high honor to present the awards in the business category. In third place is Shane Sapowski, Jupiter High School. In second place is Ethan Tooby, Spanish River High School. And the winner is Mark Heitzig, St. Andrews. So if Mark looks familiar, he was on stage earlier this evening accepting the Cantor Foundation scholarship. So we already know that an entrepreneurial spirit defines him both in and out of school. As president 2 years in a row of Junior Achievement, he's directed several successful fundraising projects. That iPhone portable charger project yielded the highest sales and return on investment in his school's Junior Achievement history. Now about those drones. Outside of school, Mark does operate a drone photography business, and he spends some of his drone time doing pro bono aerial photography for charity events. When he ascends to MIT, he will major in business analytics with a minor in entrepreneurship and innovation. He says he hopes to continue developing his entrepreneurial spirit through college and see where that takes him, with the goal of creating an initiative that solves a widespread problem and redefines an industry. Congratulations, Mark. Congratulations. Great job.
Okay, to present the Art Awards is Paul Fisher, owner of Fisher Gallery. Oh, and Liza.
Seriously, it was very, very difficult to narrow it down. We looked at so many talented artists, almost 40 artists, and my fellow judges, Liza Niles from the Armory Arts Center and Marcy Koch from the Norton Museum of Art. We looked at young artists who showed so much skill, creativity, professionalism, and we saw artworks that were sometimes intensely personal, that were very powerful, and that were, you know, truly avant-garde. And here's what all these artists had in common with every Pathfinder nominee that's here tonight. You are all exceptional human beings, exceptional people. And it's a lot of work to be awesome, and you probably don't get to enjoy that, but you are, so do enjoy that. Okay, tonight, the third place goes to Alyssa Macchia from Jensen Beach High School. Second place, Renee Campbell Hutz, Jupiter High School. And the winner is Celia Gerber from Dreyfus School of the Arts.
Don't believe me, just why? Don't believe me, just why? Don't believe.
Yeah.
Hi, Celia. Congratulations. Celia Gerber's academic life revolves around art. Besides excelling at the Dreyfus School, earning the AP Scholar with Honor distinction, she has attended prestigious art programs around the U.S. throughout her high school career. They include the San Francisco Art Institute last summer, the Oxbow School in Napa, California in the fall of 2015, where she completed a one-semester high school program, the School of the Art Institute of Chicago in 2015, where an installation she created was chosen for the front cover of the 150 years of SAIC ECP Summer Institute 2016 brochure, and the Art of the Farm Summer Program at Cowhouse Studios in Ireland, summer 2014. Celia plans to study studio art and cinematic arts or film in college and work in the film industry as an art director. Congratulations.
Our final award category, Academic Excellence, will be presented by Louise Grant, Executive Director of the Mary and Robert Pugh Public Foundation Education Fund. Louise is a longtime Pathfinder board member as well. Thank you, Louise.
Thank you. Good evening. It is my pleasure to announce this year's Academic Excellence recipients. On behalf of co-judges Jason Cornell and Greg Haar, we want you to know that this year's 42 nominees were absolutely stellar. In addition to their outstanding academic achievements, this year's candidates, more than ever, conveyed through their interviews a keen interest in the welfare of humanity. As future leaders, be assured that our world is in good hands as they use their academic gifts to promote the greater good. And nominees, please know that your academic credentials and your commitment to people and to building a better world made our decision extremely difficult. The third place winner is Philip Taylor of Oxbridge Academy of the Palm Beaches. Second place, Jack Yan, Dreyfus School of the Arts. This year's recipient is Selene Nguyen, Palm Beaches. Academic excellence for Selene Nguyen isn't a goal, but rather a vehicle for helping her help the less fortunate. With 10 medical mission trips to third world countries on her resume, she plans to earn an MD, PhD dual degree in medicine and biomedical engineering, and then set up medical humanitarian missions in the US and abroad. She also hopes to develop technology to improve medical procedures. Among numerous accomplishments, Selene has conducted a two-year study with hydrogels on marginal soils, investigating ways to make them more suitable for farming. She's excelled in numerous academically rigorous math and science classes and won prestigious recognition, finalist in the Intel International Science and Engineering Fair in the Environmental Engineering category, and awarded the AP Scholar with Honor Award. She will graduate with a Distinguished Merit ACE diploma. Congratulations.
Thank you, Louise. I am just blown away. You guys are amazing. Every year, it's unbelievable, and we are so proud of all of you, every single high school senior in this room. Just being here tonight proves that you are all winners, not only to your school, but to your community as well. Congratulations.